everybody. I'm the guy who does the Killer Solos blog, killersolos.wordpress.com, and that song is, of course, Edgar Winter's Frankenstein. Every part except for the drums and guitars was done using the standard virtual instruments that come with Logic Pro, even the bass. I've decided to make some videos to show people the techniques I use to transcribe these pieces, particularly the process of turning audio coming out of the speakers into a pretty equivalent MIDI sequence in a track in Logic. For the lesson, I've selected the Max Middleton clavinet riff from the song Play With Me from Jeff Beck's album Wired. Let's listen to the riff. Okay, now your job will be a lot easier if you beatmap the song you want to figure out. Beatmapping is the process of taking already recorded music like our Jeff Beck tune here and overlaying a musical structure, key signatures, beats, and measures on top of it. SF Logic Ninja has a good video on how to do beatmapping. I've already beatmapped the song, so let's turn on the metronome and see if it sounds like it's on the beat. Okay, sounds good. But there's a lot going on there, so we need to slow things down, ideally without changing the pitch, and we can do that in Logic using a feature called Vary Speed. Vary Speed can slow a piece down to as slow as half speed, or speed it up, or alter the pitch. It works on both audio and MIDI tracks. Of course, we're interested in slowing it down. Vary Speed doesn't appear in the control window by default, so we need to right-click or control-click on the control window to customize the control bar and then enable it. Now that we've got Vary Speed enabled, let's use it to slow down the piece. First, I'll set it to 25%, let you hear that. Oops. Cool. So now we'll go all the way to 50% and hear what that sounds like. It's a little more distorted, but boy, you can really hear the part. Okay, now there's no rules here, so we're going to start with just the left hand. And you can record the left hand and the right hand part separately. That's actually really useful if you're scoring, because then it's unambiguous what goes in the bass clef and what goes in the treble clef. So I can loop that at two measures, I can loop it at one measure. And I can even go to two beats if I'm trying to isolate a part. Think you can figure that out? Oops. So there you go. All right. Now the two figures are almost the same, so I can just sit here and work on the two measures. Ah, key is C, good for keyboard players. Thank you. All right, that's the left-hand part. Okay, now for the purposes of scoring, we're ready to record. I really don't have the piece down enough to get the feel if I was actually trying to make it like a killer solo, but for the purposes of getting on paper, yeah, no problem. All right, so we're ready to record this, and I wasn't kidding about recording the hand separately, so I'm going to go ahead and record the left hand here. Now, I like to loop the part and have it just create a take folder where it, in each successive loop, it basically records a new take in the same track. And we find that in record preferences, which are in project settings. And this, yeah, you want create take folders right here. Okay, so I'm going to record the left hand. All right, cool. Now I want to do the right hand, and I'm going to do that on a separate track. So I want to click on the track here, go up to Track, Other, New Track with Duplicate Settings, set this track to record, mute the prior track, and here we go. All right, that sounded pretty good. Unmute the track, go to the score window, and let's see what we've got. Tracks are reversed. There we go. Okay, sounds sloppy, but looks quite good. Of course, lesson after lesson could be done on how to get stuff to look great in the scoring editor. But for now, I'm pretty happy with that. I'm going to go ahead and get the rest of the piece recorded and not make you guys watch that. All right, let's put it all together and listen to it at speed. Did you hear some popping in there? It didn't sound too good. I think that the audio, I have the buffer settings too low. Boy, you want this IO buffer slice to be as low as possible because latency will move your part off of where you actually played it. I hate that. All right, let's see how this looks now. All right. Okay, well, there's way more to it than that. And I got to have a lesson on how to figure out the voicings, like to get the clav to sound really right, a bunch of other stuff. But that concludes the first lesson. Go off and transcribe a killer solo.